I'm going to introduce the main components or parts for the reefer. From outside look, we can tell this is a condenser coil, and we have another condenser coil on the curb side. They used to give off the heat from the load inside. Let's open the door and check it out inside. So, because this door is different design, a lot of driver, they cannot open completely. But as long as you open this much, that's enough. This is the engine of the reefer. It's a diesel engine, 4 cylinders. And this is an air filter. This is fuel filter. And we're going down. This is the oil filter. And we have a small generator here to provide the power for the fan. And then on the right side, the belt for the generator and the belt for the water pump. On the right side, this section is the control box and the battery. Then we move to the left side, we can see this is a compressor. They're making cool and heat. And we can move to the left side again. We open the door by just put this latch out. We have the fuel pump here. When the unit is running, you should hear the fuel pump is clicking. Also, if you touch it, it's vibrating. When the unit is running and it's not vibrating, the fuel pump might be defective. And we have the whole section of the refrigeration components on this side. The most thing we need to pay attention is this glasses here. We can see there's a ball under. When the unit is running in cool mode, after 10-15 minutes, sometimes 30 minutes, when this ball is not going all the way up, that means you might not have enough freon or refrigerant inside the system. The unit might not be cool enough. Sometimes it will come out a cold 26, 32, or 21, or some other codes. If it's lit at the bottom, it doesn't mean it's low on freon. It has to meet a few conditions, but that is out of the range. We don't need to know that. And then we move to the right side. Let's close the door. We have the battery here, and then the control box. I'm going to show you how to operate this display later on. And this is the status light at the corner. It's very important that this light is working so that you know when you're driving from the rear mirror, you can tell the reefer is working or not. I will show you later those different status light. This is a status light. If you tell the reefer operation or not, it's very important. The driver can tell from the rear mirror to see the unit is running or not when you're on the highway. It has three status of the conditions. We'll explain it more later on.